least meet me halfway. Aren't you even prepared to do that?
I don't know.
Oh, I don't know, I don't know. That's all I ever get from you. Well, listen, you better make your mind up, because I'm not hanging around. Either you make the decision or I will.
Look, I've told you before to stop encouraging him. I'm not having him grabbed to be a no-hoper like you and your father. A bloody good mind to have you charged with kidnapping.
Well, that was a stupid thing to do. You could have at least let them know he was okay. They could have brought the cops in.
They wouldn't have done that.
They could have, you know. It would have served you right if you copped a kidnapping charge.
Oh, don't be stupid, Jim. How can I be charged with kidnapping my own son? Wasn't fair the way they treated Dad. I know he wasn't a big businessman or nothing, but he'd do you a good turn before he'd do you a bad one.
Come on, love. Blow your nose. Still got that headache?
No. Dad and I, we really got on together. He was real proud of me. He used to tell his punting mates I'd be the first female bookie on course. Then he died. I didn't have no one shoot.
Well, what about your mum?
Oh, she was always around Glynis's place talking about curtains and things. That didn't do nothing for me, so I used to take off on my own. I got mixed up with this really crazy crowd. Well, I didn't know any better. Anyway, there I was, 15 years old, preggers and the whole family giving me a hard time.
Was that when your sister wanted to adopt him?
Yeah. Well, no, not official-like, you know. But they made me swear in a stack of Bibles I wouldn't say nothing about it.
And you agreed to that?
Oh, what else could I do, Jude? I was 15. I think I was glad it worked out that way then. But just recently, I've been thinking, well, it's not fair, is it? I mean, he is my kid.
All right, ladies, that's it. Order book closed. Oh, well, come on, use your heads. I've got to sneak the stuff in. It's not delivered by the truckload.
Well, hang on a minute. I still got a packet of fags on my list. Who wants some?
They're mine. You promised me if there were any left over... Hold on. Let's be fair about this. Why not ask your mate Smith? She hasn't ordered anything yet.
Well, do you want them, B?
Do I want what?
The fags. Do you want them? I just thought I'd ask.
If you thought at all, you wouldn't be doing this.
Well, it's not doing no harm, is it? I mean, it was a real good thing to have when we lost our buyer, wasn't it?
Now, how did we lose our buyer? Does anyone remember? Well, I'll remind you. We lost our buyer because Mackenzie bashed Maxine. Now, she bashes a mate of yours and you pay her back by making her rich. Oh, what's the use? Get back to work. But you can't get booze at work. Keep this up and you'll lose them all together. You know that, don't you?
And you'll take over, I suppose. That's what this is all about, isn't it?
What, me, top dog? You gotta be joking. No, too much like hard work. I tell you what, though. You keep them in line and I'll rip them off. That'll suit me just fine.
Ah, good. Thought I'd missed you. Wouldn't care to authorise this before you go, would you?
What is it?
Kitchen supplies?
Oh, damn, I forgot. What about us? Do you want me to get something on the way home?
No, no, I fixed all that this morning. There's a casserole in the fridge for tonight.
All right. Yeah.
Good.
Meg. I saw Patrick yesterday.
No. That is your business. I don't wish to interfere.
I would like you to know, and I think you've got the right to know. When I left Patrick, I said that I wanted to find myself. Oh, I've made a good job of that, haven't I? All right. What happened with Chris, it was wrong, but it did happen. There's nothing I can do about it now. It's over. And hopefully I've woken up to myself.
Glad to hear.
Janice Young is out in 3 days. Hope I haven't caused too much damage.
G'day, love.
Hi, Lou.
What'll it be? And remember, I'm a married man.
Why? Do you keep forgetting?
What's up, love? You don't look too happy.
Oh, I just feel a bit down today, Lou. You seen Murray?
No. Hang on. Snow was meant talking about him earlier. Snow.
Yeah.
Go and buy your girlfriend a drink and tell her where Murray is. Beer, love.
Oh, yeah, might as well.
You're not still doing your dabble in the Gigi's, are you?
No, I'm going to pick out a couple of barkers for tonight.
The dogs? You're mad, you know that, don't you?
Yeah, silly as a rabbit. You seen Murray?
No, he's gone up to the country meetings.
Thanks, Liv. Oh, listen, Liv, you wouldn't happen to have Bill Preston's phone number, would you?
It's on the cover of the Yellow Pages. What are you going for?
Miss Piggy in the fifth. Get some change for the phone. I've got to see a man about a dog.
See you tomorrow.
Well, how's that for good timing?
Well, not very good, actually. Yeah. Visiting hours are over for the day.
Oh, what a shame. Well, perhaps you'll do a lonely man a favour. Have dinner with me.
I don't think that's a very good idea. However, there are things we should talk about.
Oh, great. Well, we'll talk over dinner.
No, sorry, Chris.
Look, I'm not going to eat on my own. Oh, looks like I'll have to ask Big Joan to keep me company.
Oh, God, Chris, just leave me alone, will you?
Look, we're going to talk over dinner or we're going to talk in the car?
All right, meet me at the flat.
It's early yet. Why don't we have a drink before we order?
I won't be staying for dinner.
Come on, love. What's wrong?
I told you. I just want to have a talk.
Well, what did you change out of your uniform for? I mean, we could have had a talk at the flat.
No, we couldn't. That's Meg's place and I've involved her too much already.
Would you care to order a drink?
Oh, yes, thanks. Gin and tonic for the lady. I'll have a beer, thanks.
Your last visit to the prison was very informative. Got the message.
What message?
I think the words cold, detached and impersonal would cover it.
Oh, I see. Well, believe it or not, I did that on purpose. I thought that was the way you wanted it. Look, maybe you're right. We should have a talk, but let's be sensible and have it over dinner, all right?
Ah! Useless bloody things. Why don't you get us some decent coffee?
I'll give it a go, Lizzie. How the hell am I supposed to do that?
You try and tear the top off these. It's a blooming waste of time. Half the coffee goes all over the floor.
Well, you'll just have to be more careful, won't you? God, I try to do me best.
Yeah, I don't know what's wrong with you, Lizzie. After all, the poor kid's only doing it out of the goodness of her heart. It's not as if she's making a profit or anything.
Well, I didn't say that, Bea. Of course I'm getting something out of it. Well, hell, I order. I'm taking all the risks.
20 cents for these bloody things. You call that taking a risk?
How much is your cut?
Oh, not much. I think the last payoff was $10.
$10, eh? And what percentage is that? 20?
Oh, no way. Nola gets 50, Roxanne gets 20, and I get 30.
Bull.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm no genius, but I can add up. And if you got 10 bucks and you're on 30%, then there is something wrong somewhere.
How do you work that out, B?
How much do you reckon Mackenzie collected last time?
Oh, 50 at least.
Yeah, that's what I make it too. And 30% of 50 is 50. So where did the rest go?
Fair go. Roxy's got to pay for the stuff, don't she?
Yeah. Or Mackenzie has to pay a fourth partner.
Now, what would we want with a fourth partner?
Now, that I'll have to find out, won't I?
Ah, Tucker at last, eh? Oh, what kind of a call was that?
Sound all right to me. What was wrong with it?
The last time he mentioned Miss Piggy was at the start.
Well, that's your fault for backing the dogs. I tried to tell you. It's a mug's game. Too easily fixed.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Get off your soapbox.
How'd you go, love? Buying drinks for the house?
Don't mention drinks, Lou. That's what her dog had just before he raced.
Why don't you shut up, Snowy? You're a real pain, you know that?
Hey, come on. Calm down.
Sorry, Lou. It just keeps rubbing it in.
How much do you do, love?
A lot. Bloody stupid.
Hey, have one on me, eh? Might change your luck.
No such thing as luck. Listen, love. I had absolutely no idea you were short of brass, but I got a line of portable tellies. You can help me flog them off.
You get it.
It's good stuff. You'll walk away with half a grand in your pocket.
Come off it, Snow. Give the kid a break. She's trying to do it the right way.
Oh, what are you talking about? I'm trying to help the lady.
Well, you can stick it. Thanks, Lou. Night.
Look after yourself, love.
Oh, who the hell's that? Don't they know we're moving tomorrow?
Oh, good day, Helen.
Hi, Lindy.
Jean.
Hi. Hey, you all right? You look a bit shaky.
Oh, yeah, I'm okay. I just had this creep follow me home, that's all.
Oh, I'll have a look.
Oh, look, sorry, mate. Jude, I'll get changed and give you a hand.
Oh,
okay?
Sure, that's all right, mate.
Hey, love. Couldn't see anyone, only Faye.
I doubt if there ever was anybody in the first place. Poor kid hasn't been the same since a pimp gave her a bad time. Oh, I hope she doesn't go back on the dope.
What's she shooting up?
Pills and grass.
Hey, listen, Jude, I've been thinking. G'day, Helen. Billy's my kid, so I'm going to try and get him back. That's only fair, isn't it?
Well, it doesn't seem fair to me.
Why not?
Look, honey, he's 15 years old. As far as he's concerned, he already has a mother.
I'm his mother, not Glynis. Oh, he's a beaut kid, Jude, and he loves me. I know he does. Besides, I can look after him as good as she can now I've got a job.
Come off it. The only money you have is what you won yesterday. Well, I don't think it's a good idea, but if you're determined, then bank that money. Make it look like you're a respectable citizen. It'll be the only chance you have.
Yeah. Right, I will.
Are you sure you don't want to help me run this place?
No way. I just want to know which chest is the Royal Dalton and which chest is the Wedgwood.
No, it's all right, Mum. I'll take care of that.
Would you like to see it?
Maybe later, thanks. There we are. $15 a bottle, eh? It's amazing. I can remember when Jan and I used to go out, have a whole night out for that. We really thought we were living it up, too.
That was before you were a success.
Yes, indeed it was. Look, I know you're having a go at me. I know you think that just because Jan's inside, I shouldn't be sitting around here enjoying myself. Isn't that right?
Something like that.
Well, why? I worked bloody hard just after we got married. Jan had everything she wanted. All right, not millionaires, but we're pretty well off. Kids get everything, they go to decent schools. Jan couldn't fit another dress in her wardrobe if she tried.
Really got it made, hasn't she?
Well, at least she doesn't have to work.
Now, just a minute. I work because I want to. I've got a job that I'm damn good at, and what's even better, I enjoy it.
Fair enough. It's lucky for you, though, isn't it? I mean, from what you've told me, there's no way you could live on your old man's wages. Oh, come on, love. What are we arguing about? Hell, we've got the same problems. I've got a stubborn wife. You've got a husband who can't get out of his own way. Look, why shouldn't we be here enjoying ourselves? Look, I'll tell you what. We're going to polish off this bottle of wine, and then I'm going to let you talk me into spending the night with you.
Been there. Done that.
Can't sleep, young. Still, I suppose it's understandable. Must be a worrying time for you. But then you're lucky you've got Mrs. Powell here to look after you.
What do you mean?
Oh, housekeepers. Meeting your husband after work.
When?
Didn't you know? Oh, I saw him during my dinner break. Oh, your husband looked real good, too. All dressed up. Going out for dinner by the looks of it.
You're lying.
Oh, now, don't get upset, young. I'm sure they'll be thinking of you. In fact, I'll bet Mrs. Powell brings you in a doggy bag in the morning.
Duck, are you still going?
No, I nearly finished. I just got to collect some things out the back. Jeez, this is a big place, isn't it?
Yeah. You know, I can remember when Mr. Doherty first started. Of course, it wasn't in this building. Just him and his secretary in a little room at the back of the florist shop.
Yeah? Some people fall on their feet, don't they?
Don't you believe it, love? Work like a navvy to get where he is. Lovely man. Because I'm not too keen on the wife, mind you. She was the secretary. Now she landed on her feet.
Why, is she worth a bit now?
He owns all this, love. He doesn't rent it. I mean, look at all this video stuff around here, worth at least $1,000 each.
$1,000? Each? You gotta be kidding.
No. Nope. Hell, that reminds me, I forgot to lock the back door. I'll meet you at the front, love.
Yeah, sure.
Right.
Whew. $1,000 each.
She said that as soon as she came out of the cell, but how could she know?
Well, apparently Joan Ferguson told her last night.
Oh, damn that bitch.
Then it's true.
Yes, but there was a reason for it. Oh, come on, Meg, I'm not that stupid. Chris was waiting for me at the gate. Joan just saw us talking.
And that's all there was to it?
Well, we did have dinner together. Only to tell him that everything was over between us.
Colleen, I have to go back to work now. I don't know how you're going to explain this, but you're going to have to say something. I mean, now that the women know it, it could be dangerous for all of us.
Mister, I organized this a week ago. I said I wanted to turn off late today.
Well, because I've got a dozen people around me here. I can't even make them a coffee or something.
Waiting for you.
Well, why would I have rung you if I didn't want it turned off then? Oh, forget about it. It's too late now anyway. Who needs it?
Don't talk. Save all your drink for the moon.
Helen, you listen to me. The next time you suggest I move, I'm going to wring your neck.
Oh, Ginny, I think it's a load of fun.
Oh, ho, ho, ho.
And I tell you what, I wouldn't mind a tumble with the one with the hat on.
Oh,
hi, Faye.
Good day, Helen.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Jude. I'll just put this upstairs and then I'll...
Oh, yeah, listen, I wanted to have a word with you.
What about?
Well, it was about what we were talking about last night, getting Billy back. You serious?
Dead serious.
Good. I mean, I don't approve, but if you've already made up your mind, then we better do something about it.
Like what?
Well, we have to contact the legal aid. You can't do it without them. And then I thought after the move, we can open that bank account, show you can really take on responsibility, okay?
Yeah, phew. Thanks, Jude.
Judy!
Huh?
Was the crystal chandelier insured?
Fair dinkum, if she did that to me, I'd knock her bloody block off.
Don't worry, she's not going to get away with it.
Bet the freak had a nice time, I'm telling you too. You know, if I had
my... Knock it off. I think you should all calm down. Like hell I will.
Will you use your head? You're going to be out of here in 2 days. If you go lashing out at Pal now, she'll keep you in here forever. If you want to fight back, do it on the outside where you've at least got a chance.
Makes sense, love.
Daniels, you've got a visitor.
I want to see you.
Later. Come on, Daniels.
No, now.
Careful, you'll be on charge.
Use your head, don't be stupid. And you be careful, don't get in court.
No, damn it.
It's her fight, B. Let her handle it her own way.
Pal, you'll talk to me now. Pal!
Wait at the security gates. You have something to say?
You and Ferguson must have had a real laugh. You think you've got it made, don't you? Lock them up and then lay their husbands. What a racket.
I won't pretend I don't know what you're talking
about. Good, then don't. And don't think you're breaking up a home either. I mean, it has happened before, but the others have had the guts to do it in the open.
Listen. I'll tell you this once, young. Nothing happened last night.
You lying bitch!
G'day, Faye. Nice and early.
Yeah, can't keep away from the skunk behind the bar. Hey, Snow.
Oh, g'day, love. What are you having?
Oh, nothing. I'm supposed to be helping shift house. You, got a minute?
Is there a dollar in it?
Be plenty.
Then I've got a minute. Oh. Get a couple of beers. What's on?
Videotape machines. Good as new. Worth about a grand each. How much?
How many? How easy to get?
3? Kid could do it.
What do you want?
300 each.
2?
Oh, come on, Snow. I haven't got time. 250.
Fair enough. How do I get them?
You write your number down. I'll contact you.
What are you doing with that, Smith?
I thought I'd have a rest from the press. My feet are killing me.
Well, don't take all day. There's 2 of you missing from the laundry now.
Wasn't Maxine back? I thought she was with you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have got your approval first, perhaps. Miss Ferguson's taken her for a visit. Is that all right for you?
I'm sorry, I was just asking. Bloody Ferguson. I knew it.
And she just said that. She didn't give any explanation. The freak?
You gotta be joking. She even waited till the lights out. Reckon she does everything in the dark.
I reckon she sleeps in a coffin too. Poor Janice must have gone through hell last night.
But what about the others? They don't seem to be like that.
A screw's a screw. Oh, come on, love. Be fair. Mrs. M's terrific. She's always doing things for us.
She spent time in here as a prisoner, didn't she?
Yeah. Oh, you've been doing your homework, haven't you? Oh, there you are, love. I thought you'd missed out. Mm, yes.
Erica Davidson?
Ted Douglas, Erica.
Oh, hello, Ted. What can I do for you?
How's Jill Clark going? Any follow-ups?
If you mean, is she still undercover? Yes, she is. Ted, I wish you'd change your mind about this. It's far too dangerous.
Rubbish. She's a good operator. Good Lord, she spent 18 months posing as a trade union executive, so I don't think your lot will worry her.
She is my responsibility, Ted, and I don't like the situation at all.
Come on, the minister's not the least bit worried, so why should you be? Oh, by the way, that's why I'm calling. He wants a progress report on her, so I'd better have a meeting with Clark.
You can't meet her here.
Why not? Nobody will see us in your office.
And how is she going to get to the office, Ted? Somebody has to bring her.
I don't know, but there must be some way around it. Anyway, I'll leave that up to you. But I want the meeting today, so when you've arranged something, just give me a call, will you?
Very well.
Stokes, creme de menthe too.
God, you lot would drink anything.
You're not kidding. She used to drink Lizzie's brew and that'd peel paint.
Look, will you hurry up? Someone will come.
All right, don't get your knickers in a twist. Next.
Me, brandy and skin perfume.
You want to be careful the freak doesn't get after you.
Will you keep it down?
Hunt, scotch and hair colour.
Hair colour? I ordered hairspray.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. What will I do with hair colour?
Yeah, all right. I tell you what, you keep that. And if you can't trade, well, I'll do a deal on the next delivery, OK?
I haven't got much choice, have I?
All right, ladies, that's it. You better nick off before Nervous Nelly over there has a heart attack. Not a bad day's work.
What the hell do you think you're up to?
Just having my coffee break. Why? Something gone wrong?
Oh, cut it out. You know damn well what I mean. Janice Young.
Young. Oh, yeah, that's right. She gets out the day after tomorrow, doesn't she? Too bad. Still, you had a little time together, I suppose.
Listen. What happens outside of this prison is none of your business. And I wouldn't start causing trouble if I were you, if you don't know the facts.
Oh, but I saw the facts. So don't preach to me, Mrs. Powell.
You think you saw the facts, and as usual, you are wrong.
And why are you so upset?
Because I want to know why you did it.
Well, I happen to think that the women have a hard enough time in here as it is without their husbands playing up on the outside.
Oh, God. Concern for the prisoners now, is it?
Yeah, that'll do. Besides, if I wanted to keep it a secret, I'd hardly meet him in broad daylight at the front gates.
And I wouldn't go around telling tales if I was as eager as you to have officer solidarity.
Oh, but I'm not. Not anymore. That sort of thing's too one-sided in here.
It's a warning. Keep away from Janice Young.
Or what? You'll tell the governor? Oh, that should be very interesting.
Took it in your
30%. Oh, B, you scared the hell out of me. I didn't see you there.
You were too busy counting your dough. You should be more careful.
Yeah, suppose so.
How did your visit with, what's her name go? Roxanne, isn't it?
Yeah, Roxy. Well, real well.
Still getting the stuff in?
Yeah, no worries.
Roxy's getting real good at it now.
Making the screws look like real idiots, eh?
Yeah. Po-Face hasn't got a clue. Every time she turns her back...
You little liar.
What do you mean?
I mean you're lying to me. Powell told me that Ferguson took you out on that visit. Not that you really had to. I've known it all along. I just didn't have the proof, that's all. You're working with the freak.
I'm sorry, B.
Not good enough, Maxine. Not nearly good enough. And you want to know why? Because I have busted a gut trying to protect you women from Ferguson. I damn nearly got myself killed. And now you are fleecing your mates just to line her pockets.
I never thought of it like that, to be honest.
No. Of course you didn't. But you're going to from now on. Because I am going to teach you a lesson.
What the hell is this? You're supposed to keep yourself tidy. Get your feet off the pillow. What's this? Where did you get this? Well,
don't you know?
Don't get smart with me, Clark. Just answer my question. All right. Come on, get outside. Let's go and see the governor.
Just hold it there, you lot.
No, keep the women moving. I'm taking Clark to see the governor.
Trouble?
Contraband.
Need any help?
Get moving.
You lot, stop work.
What happened, B? You look dreadful.
Like I've been trying to tell you, a couple of people around here have been treating the rest of you like idiots. One goes by the name of Mackenzie, the other is a so-called mate, Maxine.
Yeah? Well, what have they done?
They've taken on a third partner, Ferguson. They've been robbing you blind and handing it straight over to the freak.
Oh, Maxie wouldn't do that. She hates Fergo as much as we all do.
Ask Mackenzie. So, what's the big deal? We've got her. We can't get rid of her. So why not use her?
You mean let her use us?
I haven't seen you turning down the booze.
Well, I didn't know it came from that bloody mongrel. What happened, B? Where's Maxie?
Looks like the little racket's finished, Mackenzie. But I'm sure you'll be able to explain that to your mate, Ferguson. Who says it's finished? Your ex-clients.
All right, ladies. Is that what you want? No more booze or decent fags?
Well, come on, tell her.
Lizzie, I just didn't think.
Of course you didn't, you silly little thing. It's this place. It's destroying us. It's destroying all of us. Did you find Maxine? Well, did you find her or didn't you?
I found her.
And?
She's in a cell. She's not feeling too good.
Yeah? I hope it's not catching. What are the symptoms? Blood nose? Black eye?
Shut your big mouth, Mackenzie.
The screws think she's got bellyache, and you'd better not let them think any different.
All right, that's enough. Just cool down.
Cool down, be buggered. She's made this place worse than it ever was. We used to know who our enemies were. Vinegar tits, Mary Winter, but now she's turned right against maintenance. Not right, B. I mean, if you haven't got mates, well, you haven't got anything.
What's happened to Maxie?
All right, now listen to this and remember it. I warned Maxine what would happen. I warned her the freak would find out about the trading racket. And I told her what would happen to her if she became involved. Well, she didn't do as she was told, so I taught her a lesson.
You bashed Maxie?
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mrs. Powell. I've been inspecting the isolation block.
When do the workmen say they'd be finished?
Thursday, according to the foreman. What's the trouble here?
I found this in Clark's cell. She refuses to say where it came from.
I see. Well, you're learning fast, Clark. Usually, first offenders cooperate with the officers.
I've no objection to telling you, Mrs. Davidson.
But not Mrs. Powell. Why?
Well, I've heard what happens to laggers, so the fewer people I tell, the better.
Are you suggesting that Mrs. Powell is involved with this contraband?
No, of course not.
Then why should anything you tell us go further than this office?
How the hell should I know? All I'm saying is that
I'm... That's enough. Insolence and possession of contraband. Would you take her to solitary, Mrs. Powell?
Mrs. Davidson, I said I'd tell you.
And I said solitary. Mrs. Powell?
Get out.
Heather, would you get Mr. Douglas for me, please? Thank you.
All right. Listen to me. I've just found contraband goods in Joe Clark's cell. Brandy, to be precise. Now, anyone care to tell me where she got it? I see. Well, Clark has just been introduced to solitary. When I find out the source of supply, and I will, it could be a very busy place. Think about it, ladies.
Yeah, think about it. Ferguson and Mackenzie are getting rich, and Jill's getting punished for it.
Yeah? Well, at least she's safe in there.
Erica, I was stopped at the main gate because the gate guard didn't know me, and just now Ferguson wouldn't let me through reception until I signed the book.
Well, there are regulations, Ted. You shouldn't be upset.
Upset? I'm delighted. Place is starting to look like a prison at last. Look, you're quite sure the staff don't know they're being watched?
Quite sure.
Then they're a credit to you.
They always have been, Ted. And now I am repaying them by allowing a departmental sneak spy on them.
Nonsense. It's normal business procedure. They expect it. It keeps them on their toes, Erica. Oh, where is our departmental sneak?
I put her on a charge and sent her to solitary. I think that's the safest place for you to see her.
Oh, dear. She won't forget us in a hurry, will she?
We'll have to go via the back stairs. Hopefully no one will see us.
Back stairs? Didn't know we had any. Well, this is a new experience. It's the first time I've had to sneak around one of my own prisons.
Yes, but you can imagine how I feel, can't you?
Oh, come on, Erica. Where's your sense of adventure? Let me just think. The screw might pop around the corner any minute, eh? look, is this the only way up there?
Yes, unless you want to be seen. Why?
Well, suppose I need the exercise. After you.
Well, you're doing a fine job. I'm sorry about this, but of course you understand it's the only way we could get to see you without raising suspicion. Now, this brandy of yours, you say it's readily available?
Brandy, scotch, you name it. Mackenzie claims she can get anything in.
Drugs?
Well, I haven't seen any as yet, but I've been told there's an officer helping them, so they wouldn't have much trouble.
Did they name the officer?
Ferguson, according to rumour, but I haven't been able to confirm it yet.
Yes, and I doubt that you will. God, it's amazing, isn't it? The minute a prison officer comes up to departmental standard, the dirt starts flying.
Yes, it makes you wonder why we even bother to try, doesn't it? I'm sorry, Mr. Douglas, but I'm afraid we'll have to be going. There's an officer due on patrol in 5 minutes.
Right, well, no, just keep up the good work, and above all, get the name of that officer, all right?
Yes, sir.
I'll be in touch.
You'll have to stay here for 24 hours.
Of course, Mrs. Davidson, I understand.
What are you doing, love? You should be resting. You shouldn't be doing things like this.
It's all right, Lizzie. I'm only making coffee, not training for the Olympics. You want one?
Yeah, but sit down. I've been worried sick about you the whole afternoon.
Do you want a coffee, Bee? I made you one.
Look, let's get something straight. I'm not sorry for what I did. I'm just sorry it had to be a mate, that's all.
Yeah, well, I'm not complaining. Probably would have done the same thing if I'd been in your shoes. Just didn't think, that's all. Nola said we may as well use the freak, so I just went along with it. And I'm sorry. I feel sorry.
Thanks. I'll take you to the rec room. Look after her, Lizzie.
Oh, Heather, the governor wants to see you. She said to take the building specifications for D Block and your notebook. And look, I can only stay for 10 minutes, so don't be too long. Hello. Yes, clerk of courts, please. Yes, it's Wentworth Detention Centre here. I wonder if you can help me. There seems to be some confusion over the sentencing of one of our prisoners. Clark. Gillian Clark.
Well, if it isn't the cripple of the month. Don't tell me you walked into another door. Shut your face, Mackenzie. Oh, there's no need to be like that, Wrinkles. I was just worried about my star employee, that's all.
Ex-employee.
Come again?
I'm not working for you no more. You can stick it.
I see. And what brought this about?
Obvious, isn't it? She's had some friendly advice from her best mate.
Yeah. Made quite an impression by the looks of things.
Lay off, Nola. You too, Phil. Bee's right. Anyone who has anything to do with the freak's a rat bag.
There you go again. Calling me names.
Well, if she doesn't, I will. You've got a choice.
Okay, Maxine. Resignation accepted. I'll just have to get Roxanne to visit someone else, that's all.
Mackenzie? Outside.
It's been pleasant talking to you. What's the problem?
What do you know about Jill Clark?
Like I told you. She's a bit nosy, but she's doing a uni thesis on prisons. Why?
Well, I've been doing some checking. There doesn't seem to be any record of her trial. As far as the courts are concerned, she doesn't exist.
A spy?
A It looks that way. So I'm warning you, Mackenzie. If anyone finds out that I'm involved in your smuggling racket, you're going to have more trouble than you can handle.
You're a bit late, I'm afraid. Smith found out.
What?
Yeah. And she told the other women. So I reckon you're the one who's in trouble, Miss Ferguson. Because when Clark gets out of solitary, she's going to find out too. Yeah. I reckon you've got big trouble.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together.